Hello everybody and welcome back to another episode of Let's Play Yakuza 0. In the last episode, we did a ton of sub-stories involving a statue man, a crossword puzzle, and this little girl right here, which we will actually continue with in a second, because I did some toy hunting in between episodes, and may have gotten a little bit carried away with... I mean, she just asked for the red chipmunk toy, but I wanted to collect them all, man, and it may have taken a bit of money. Come on, 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 come on. Yes, 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 no, 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 no! That's right, that's right. Come on, come on. I wasn't even close. I wasn't even close. Oh my god, yes, no, damn it. No, you stupid birdie bastard! I'm gonna get you! I'm gonna get you! You shall be mine! And a bit of my sanity, but before we go on any further, there is something that I need to say, and unfortunately, this is just an unfortunate thing that happened in between episodes. So after the last episode finished, I actually stopped recording and then went to go to a save point, and then a blackout happened, or a power surge, or something happened in my neighborhood because everyone's electronics went out, and I had to redo everything all over again. So just to let you know what has changed, I actually did the crossword puzzle perfectly this time, and because of that, if I go to my, I think it's under inventory and then parts, yeah, I got a different reward. I got a pearl instead, or three pearls even, which is a better reward. And also, if I go to my equipment, the stuff I got for the agent, like Fei Hu and his wife, that stuff, when he went away, I didn't get as good a rewards this time. So yeah, that's a bit unfortunate, you know, those things happen. So just to let you know, those are the only things that have changed. Of course, money will be slightly different, but that isn't too important. And I tried my best to make everything else exactly the same. So without further ado, little lady, I have a red squirrel with your name on it. What? You still staring at that chestnut squirrel doll? Huh? Oh, yeah, I am. I have one of those red chestnut squirrel dolls now. Maybe I ought to give it to her. Here you go, little one. Ah, fine, here. Man, I really like that cute little squirrel.
Wow, it's a red chestnut, the squirrel. It's adorable.
Yeah, well, it ain't exactly my thing, so why don't you keep it? Majima, that is a lie. I made it our thing. I went through a lot to get those toys.
Really? Thanks, sir. I never got a present from anyone besides my mom before. Best day ever.
That's so. Well, glad you like it. Now, will you get on home?
Yeah. I'm gonna tell my mom all about it. Thanks, sir. Bye.
Boy, a little scamp's a handful. But it feels kind of nice to make a day like that. Man, Majima was always a cool character with a cool backstory. And obviously, this game will go into its backstory. I know that, so, you know, spoilers. So I don't want to say anything about it, but it's really nice to see that he's got a nice side as well, because all of the other games just made him out to be a really cool guy. And it's nice to see a different kind of cool side from him. Anyway, that being said, let's take out these thugs. God, I'm not sure what that is when that happens. I think what it is I'm hitting the environment, because it sort of just clangs off something sometimes with Slugger style. So, I'm gonna have to keep that in mind, because I need to be careful about that. Boom! Doesn't matter, fuck will do. God, I'm so glad there's bridges here, it's so useful for taking out goons. Alright, one more. Boom! I think that's the coolest grab animation in the game so far. I mean, Kiryu has some pretty good ones, but that one's just stylish as all hell. Anyway, okay, I've been seeing you. What's your deal, buddy? What the? What's with this creeper?
Hey, you.
Hey, oh wait, no, that's Majima. Hey, you, this is no napping zone. Why don't you get up and move along? Urgh, I'm hurt.
Did this guy get a snot kicked out of him? He's in so much pain, he can't even talk. Alright, here's some medicine. Let's see, what do we got? Torina. I think we can give up the Torina. Here you go, pal. Drink this. You alright?
Hi.
Yes! I'm feeling much better now. Thank you. Well, let's tell me what happened. Why did you get laid out? It's because I was chasing a dream. Here we go. What's all this about a dream? It's my dream to boldly walk across a bridge. Oh, right. A grand old dream like walking across this bridge sure does explain why you got beat to an inch of your life. Except not really. Huh? I mean, come on. It wouldn't take more than a minute or two to just stroll right across this bridge. But it's not that simple. And why is that? It's because of this statue I've been wearing. What? Oh, no. You don't know what a statue is? That's terrible. You're not with the times at all. So not cool. Is that supposed to be statue or stagion? Oh, stadium. Okay, I'm going to call it stagion then. Stagion is short for stagion jumper. It's a jacket worn by athletes at stadiums so they can stay warm and limber. Overseas, they call these varsity jackets, but in Japan, it's stagion all the way. Neat. But why in the world would wearing a stagion make it so you couldn't cross oh my god. Just continue, please. Well, you put on a jacket like this and you pop the collar, and suddenly everyone thinks you're some kind of big shot. All the punks come charging out looking for blood. Maybe if the jacket didn't say bring on the fights. I've tried crossing 8 times now, but every time, goons show up and beat the crap out of me before I can make it. That's certainly a, unique problem. There's gotta be other dudes wearing jackets like that, right? They aren't all game mauled by the riffraff. Right? I can't explain it, but when I do it, I get so much heat. Does my face piss people off, or is this just my destiny? Destiny's an asshole if that's the case. Alright, at least I get why you're bleeding out on the pavement here. Yeah. So here's a novel idea. Maybe take off the stagion? Seems to me that's the source of all your woes. But that defeats the purpose! I love this stagion! You wouldn't believe how much trouble I went through to get this sweet jacket. I want to wear it loud and proud. That's my dream! Well, it's a free country, but I wager you've got another beating coming down the pipe if you go through with it. That's what complicates things. Oh, I'm sorry. How rude of me. My name is Suda. 51? Is that you? Suda-chan, huh? I'm Majima. Majima-san, if you don't mind me saying, you look like a man who can wade into brawls and walk away without a hair out of place. Well, I've got a hair tie, but yeah, I can hold my own. Majima-san, I'm sorry if this sounds wimpy, but do you think you could help me make my dream come true? Huh? What do you mean? I know it's probably an imposition, but do you think you could fend off goons while I strut proudly across Aweo Bridge? You're not kidding about this being an imposition. I'm sorry, but without the help of a guy like you, my dream will forever be unfulfilled. I'll have a lifetime of regret. Please, Majima-san, please help me realize my dream! Oh my god. So the sub-story is literally helping a guy cross a bridge because people want to beat the shit out of him. Alright, let's do it. I'm a pretty tough guy, so I think I can handle it. Oh, alright, fine, I'll help you. You really do this? You mean it? I mean, I know I asked, but I didn't expect to meet a person kind enough to get me into a fist fight for me. Yes, story of my life, but you're serious about this stagion drawing out goons like flies on rotten fruit?
Hi.
Oh, yes, totally. Just watch. You better not make me use another medicine on you.
Hmm?
Hmm?
Hey, you. You think you're hot shit in that jacket? You trying to start something, huh? See? Yeah, I'm seeing it. Can't tell if that's the... Can't tell if it's that stage on or you drawing that all this aggro, though. Okay, I'm going to strut proudly down this bridge. But please keep me safe. Enjoy your stroll, bud. These punks are gonna pay the toll for the troll. This is... really weird. But that's Yakuza for you. Okay. So I just need to protect you, right? That's a lot of goons. I can't believe you actually attract this many. Right, it's batting time. Come on! They're not even trying to focus on me! This is weird. Come on! Show me everything you've got! Alright. Anyone else? Come on, this can't be it. There must be someone else. Yeah, that's what I was expecting. Okay, I know you're strutting yourself, but could you strut yourself a little bit faster, please? That being said, he does take some hits like a champ. Come on! I took out a few of them. Boom! Oh, God. Well, that could have gone a lot better. Wasn't expecting that many of them. No, it's alright. I got close. Next time, maybe. Sure. You want persistent bastard, huh? I sure am. I'm ready to try again whenever you are, Majima-san. Sure. Don't worry, buddy. I'm not giving up just yet. Damn it. I think this time we got it. Oh yeah, third time's the charm. Yes! I finally did it. I made it all the way across Aweo Bridge while wearing my beloved stadium. Heh. Good for you. Yes, thank you, Majima-san. You made my dream come true. I'd like you to have this. It's the best I can do as my thanks. You got the encounter finder. I don't think I've ever been this happy. I'll never forget what you did for me today. Heh, cruising around in a jacket, is that a good deal to you? You're an odd dude. I know, I don't think most people would understand how much this meant to me, but still, it was my dream. Yeah, I guess that's true of most dreams. Sorry, I shouldn't call you odd. Eh? No need to apologize, Majima-san. I owe you a life debt. You never need to apologize to me, ever. Heh, I take it back. You're an odd dude, Suda-chan. I guess so. I get told that often. Well? After that most satisfying accomplishment, I'm hungry. I'm going to head for home and food. Heh, see ya. Good luck on those bridges. Yes, thank you and goodbye. All in all, that wasn't too bad. I guess it ain't so much about what others think of you. If it's something you want to do, you better get to it. Suda-chan was pretty weird. But his philosophy's right on. There's a real man. Huh? Hey, what's with the hard-ass stage on? You trying to be funny? Bring on the fights, huh? Let's get it on then.
Help!
Take it off and go home, man. Ah. I love Majima's reaction to things. It's just so perfect. Well, I went to get some food and restore my health, even though I was actually at full health, but whatever, and look who I happened to come across. Hey there. You back, kiddo? I told you it's dangerous to hang around here alone.
Hey, sir?
How about you drop the surfing, huh? Now, what's got you hanging around here now? Come on now, speak up when someone asks you a question.
I'm looking at the blue chestnut, the squirrel doll.
What? Now it's the blue one that you got your eyes on?
Yeah, the blue chestnut is super cute too.
If you say so. So, you got your heart set on that now?
No, you got me one the other day, and I'm happy to have it. I'm not greedy. I don't have a daddy. My mummy is at work all the time, and she says there's no money for frivolous things, so I just wanted to come and look at it.
Hmm. Well, you ought to head home soon. Don't want your mum worrying about you, do you?
I know. I just want to look at it a little longer, then I'll go home.
Every second you stick around this part of town, you risk too much, kiddo. Only way to keep us safe is to grab the blue squirrel when I get a chance. Well, it just so happens that I happen to have a double. That is like M. Night Shyamalan levels of sentence. Anyway. What? You still staring at the chestnut squirrel doll?
Huh? Oh, yeah, I am.
I have one of those blue chestnut dolls right now. Yeah, I have two of them. Look, here's a blue chestnut squirrel.
Wow! It's a blue chestnut the squirrel!
You take care of him. Squirrels ain't my thing.
Really? I can't believe it! Everyone's gonna be so jealous when I show them at school tomorrow.
Jealous of that little thing?
Yeah! The other kids always talk about their daddies buying them dolls, and they show them to each other. I get left out whenever that happens, but now I have something to talk about.
I'm glad for you, scamp. But I ain't your daddy.
I wouldn't really know, but don't daddies buy things for kids?
I suppose it depends. Well, that's a dad thing, yeah?
I knew it! So, if I did have a daddy, he'd be kind of like you, right?
Huh? How you figure?
Because you gave me two dolls.
I did, but...
See? And you look old enough to be a daddy, so you're just like a daddy to me.
How old does this kid think I am?
I wish you could be my real daddy, sir.
Whoa. You know that ain't gonna happen, right?
Well, can I just call you daddy then?
Say what?
Oh, you don't want me to.
My choices are sir or daddy, huh? Ain't too fond of either, but what's the right play here? Oh my god. Does it matter? I mean... Sure, just call me... This feels really weird. It'll make her happy. Call me whatever you want. I don't care.
Really? Yay! I like daddy best then.
I'm getting some mixed feelings here, kiddo. Yeah, you and me both, buddy. You best get a You best get back to your mom.
Okay, bye, Daddy.
You take care on your way home. Oh my god. Well, I guess that's a thing now. Well, I beat up a super rich guy and it gave me enough money in order to upgrade my abilities, which I actually haven't shown off in a while, so I think I'll show you because I got some stuff in the slugger. Mainly stuff like charge attack and this unique thing which lets me do an attack from a style switch and a running assault while running, but the main two things worthy of note are these two because they increase my health but also let me train, so I'm gonna pay our good old Chinese weapon master a visit. Yo, weapon master, what's up?
Once you become familiar with weapons, Majima-san, I will teach you new ways to wield them.
Yeah.
That really gonna be necessary. I ain't gotta be a genius to work out which way's the pointy end.
Consider it part of my service. It would be a shame to leave the full power of weapons you obtain from me untapped.
Uh-huh. I'm just saying. I got my own way of doing things. But, hey, if you'll go through the trouble, I'll hear you out.
I would also recommend you work at honing your bad skills. There is wealth of hidden potential there.
You think so? I don't know. I kind of figured Batmeat's head was pretty much to the extent of it. Yeah.
No, you have much more to learn. By my estimation, your bat technique would improve more deadly than even swordplay if you develop it. More deadly than a sword? You serious? Quite. The bat and the katana are alike in length. They say some baseball players purchase a katana and practice their swings with them to heighten their focus. But considered as another class of weapon, the bat's weight, resting at the far tip, yields exceptional destructive power, making it distinctly different from a blade.
Yeah, they're obviously two different things, but principle's not so far off, right?
Yeah. I'm telling you, there are techniques you could perform with a bat that simply wouldn't be possible using other weapons. I suggest you work on uncovering these.
Huh. You're making a big deal out of this, but a bat's a bat if you ask me. You just whack people with them.
This is a truly groundbreaking technique. I will teach you new weapon skills as you progress, but I ask you show me your bat fighting skills in return.
I'll show you anything you want, but I ain't exactly the professor type. Hey, I got an idea.
Yeah. What is that?
When you teach me new weapon moves, how about you take me on with that weapon? I'll fight back with a bat.
It would be difficult for you to pick up new techniques that way, I fear. I believe it is better to begin by learning the proper stance and forms.
What? You gonna make a pro bowler start by playing catch? We ain't exactly amateurs here. I'd rather get a feel for a weapon naturally in a fight.
I see. I suppose that method may be better suited to you.
I've been looking forward to doing another round with you anyway. Heh. This should be fun.
Heh. Perhaps that is your true motive. Well, I will be here when you are ready to continue your training.
And you know what? I think I can start my training right now.
Have you been working on your bat techniques, Majima-san? I can teach you about the following weapons.
Poles and Kali sticks. Let's go with poles.
You wish to learn the pole? Then we will train in air to combat as suggested, Majima-san. Are you healthy and ready to fight?
Yep. Ready as I'll ever be. Yeah, I'm good.
Then let us go outside.
Oh man, I get to learn weapon stuff. I'm getting flashbacks of Shinada here.
The pole techniques I'm about to show you were passed down through generations in China.
Uh-huh. Ah, so we're doing real traditional shit now.
Yeah. I am from Taiwan myself, but many techniques originating in China can be found there. The reach differs from a bat, as does the speed of the spinning attacks.
Interesting. Let's see it in action then.
I look forward to getting another look at your bat techniques. We should avoid using our most powerful moves. Alright, here I come!
Oh yeah, it's the good theme! Let's go!
Boom!
I'll show you just how much I've learned! Okay, okay. Man, the defense on this thing is pretty good. Alright, there we go. I'm pretty sure I'm hitting the environment, so that's one thing that I need to keep in mind when using a bat. Okay, break your guard! Boom! One, two, three, spin it around! Break your guard! Okay, not quite. Come on! Break it, damn you! Okay, don't want to go down to first bar. Oh, damn it. Come on, there we go. Ooh. This is like an old Chinese kung fu movie. It's pretty cool. I think that's what the music was trying to be a reference to. Yeah, suck it, ancient martial arts.
Well done, Majima-san. Let us go back to the store. I knew you could do it, Majima-san. I tried to slip my attacks past your defenses, but the sheer force of your strikes overwhelmed me.
Yeah, I'm tenacious like that.
You were spinning that thing so fast, I thought you'd take off. Not too shabby on the defense either, huh?
The pull allows you to protect your lower body as well. Try using it when up against multiple foes or opponents that target your legs.
Yeah, got it.
Thank you for visiting Dragon and Tiger.
You completed weapon training pole! Let me take a look what that actually does in my ability menu. Let's see, weapon training pole. Proof that you've learned to use the pole, but you'll need more training to call yourself a master. Also usable with other battle styles. Applies to all of Majima's styles. Interesting, so I guess this lets me equip poles? And then I can use them? Interesting. And then I can get the Weapon Master Bat. Your weapon durability won't drop when wielding a bat as long as you remain calm. Oh, okay, so... That's interesting, because it's not so much making me gain heat, it's actually better if I don't gain heat. Interesting. Okay, I'll keep that in mind. However, before we go on to the next training, let's see if the little girl has appeared. Yep, just as I thought. It's that little girl standing all by herself again. What's she got on her eye this time? What's she got on her eye? Well, 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 look who it is. I guess I shouldn't have expected any different. Which one is it now?
Daddy? You scared me.
You really got your eye on these dolls, don't ya?
It's just a pink bunch and looks really pretty.
Yeah, pretty or not. Didn't I tell you how dangerous this area can get? You're not looking for trouble, are ya?
No, I'm sorry.
Here we go again.
Oh, God. Oh, God, that was some phlegm.
A pink bunchan, huh? We'll see if I can get her one.
Have I got one of those already? Hang on, let me check. From my collection of dolls, I should really, really put in the item box. And yes, I actually do have one. God damn it, I'm giving away my collection. Actually, one thing that I should probably notice, One thing I should probably note is this one right here. It says right there, main character from the famous shooting game Fantasy Zone, which was like a Sega Mega Drive game. It was pretty cool. It was like a shoot-em-up. And it was revolutionary because you could shoot both directions instead of just scrolling one direction. Anyway. Here, I've got it for you. I'll have to collect another one a different time. Here you go. A bouncy little bunchin.
Wow, a real pink bunchin. Thank you so much.
Say, how come you like dolls so much?
Oh, I'm just all alone when I'm at home. Having my squirrels around feels like I have friends over. That's why dolls are the best.
Yeah, that's nice.
And now Bunchin gets to join the family. Thanks for everything, Daddy. I'm going to take such good care of them.
Yeah, yeah. Now off you go. Back to your mom.
Okay, bye-bye.
Maybe now the tea party's complete. No reason for her to hang around here anymore, I hope. God, we're making real progress with that.
God, her mom must have so many questions. She'll just get home and she'll be like, "Hey, mommy, daddy gave me another toy today, and she'll just be like, "Who is this daddy you're speaking about?" Anyway. Kali sticks. Teach me about them.
You wish to learn Kali sticks? Then we will train in actual combat.
Let's go.
Kali sticks consist of two short sticks. They are usually made from wood called rattan. Have you heard the word Kali before, Majima-san?
Nope. Enlighten me.
Kali is actually the name of a martial art in the Philippines. It is their national sport. The word Kali comes from the local language. The word spread throughout the United States, and the word sticks was added. I'll leave out the details, but their practicality has made them popular around the world.
A weapon from the Philippines, huh? Who would have thought? But you really think they're world famous?
Yes. It is easy for simple weapons such as these to take root.
Well, maybe they're just taking off here in Japan then. Only thing I've seen that uses two-stitch saw taiko drums.
Haha, do not underestimate their potential to cause harm. Sure, let's get the show on the road then. I look forward to getting another look at your bad techniques. We should avoid using our more powerful moves. Alright, here I come.
You know, it only took me till now to realize that when he says that, he means I'm not allowed to use heat moves. But I guess that makes sense. Oh my god, you have more health. And that is very fast. Damn. Okay, let's go out into the open so you don't make me hit the environment. Or maybe he guards. I actually think I saw a guarding animation. Maybe... No, it has to be the environment. Come on. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Boom. Damn, I actually really like this move so much. Oh my god, we are just armoring the shit out of each other. That was really cool. Okay. Get out of here. God! His armor's better than mine, though. Okay, let's try out this running move. Because, ow, I haven't given it a try yet. That seems pretty effective. As long as I don't actually, ow, get hit in the face. I'm just gonna cheat and use a stamina. God! Okay, don't try to out-armor him. His armor's better. Okay, wait for you to... Oh, God! Damn, you're pretty good. 1, 2, 3... Yeah, try and armor through this, sir! Come on. Oh, damn it. Oh, I had him. Boom! God, I love this style so much. I'm not sure if it's my favorite one, but it's up there. There we go. Okay, this is definitely the move to use. If I just keep on doing this combo, he seems to have trouble. Only problem is, it doesn't do the most damage in the world. Okay, get away from you, get away from you. Boom! Damn, he didn't even flinch! Guess that's why they call him the Weapon Master. Here we go, this should finish it! Okay, or not. There we go. Yeah! Sticks lose!
Well fought, Majima-san. Let us return to the store.
Hi.
Excellent fight, Majima-san. I attempted to shut down your offense with my own attacks, but I ended up being overpowered.
You really were getting up in my face. Is that the right way to use those things?
I believe they are best used to press the attacks, rather than defend. If you land enough blows, you can even stun opponents, making them ideal against swift foes.
Got it.
Thank you for visiting the Dragon and Tiger.
You completed weapon training Cali Sticks. Oh yeah, making our way up in the world. Also, before we leave, I probably should send an agent out, because I haven't done that. Okay, so... I can craft equipment, sell equipment, repair equipment. Let's just do an equipment search. Oh my god, we got a bunch of new places. Right. These ones are pretty expensive. Let's see. What we got in Japan? So we got bat, golf club, spray, stun gun, sword, umbrella, dagger, knife, binding. Okay. I'm just gonna send someone here again. I want some more bat stuff. And, oh my god, is that who I think it is? I think it is. I think it's a young version of him. I can't remember his name.
Oh my god, it's the weapon dealer from the freaking earlier Yakuza. Oh my god. Well, anyway, he seems to be the best one here, so... Let's see, timber, metal bat, spiked bat. Yeah, you seem to be the best shot. I'm gonna send you. Oh, and I can do the extra funds. Let's see. I have 800,000 yen. It's 160,000. Okay, if I do this, what happens if I bring it up to a nice round? Yeah, I'll just do it regular. Actually, wait, hang on. How much? Oh, okay, that's... Okay, I was seeing how much it changes on the side there. So if I do this... If I give him all of my money... Which I'm not going to do. Right. I'll give you an extra 100,000.
What do you want?
I think that'll be it for now. Thank you. Well... Let's go see if that little girl is there one last time. Huh? What the? It's that doll girl bawling her eyes out. Oh my god, what happened? What's the matter, scamp? Huh? What is this? The doll I gave you got all messed up. Who did this? I want names.
My mom. My mom! My mom's gonna get killed!
What?
Scary man who came to take money showed up, but this time they took her away. And they did this to your...
And they did this to your doll, huh? Do you have any idea where they took your mom?
Down by the river, I think.
Alright, come on, kiddo. We gotta bust a move. Oh, some suckers are gonna pay. I spent ages getting that doll!
Stop it! I already paid you back everything I borrowed.
What are you talking about, you dozy cow? We lent you 1,000,000 yen, remember?
But I paid it back by the due date!
Are you really that dense?
You ain't paid a drop off at the interest yet.
By my calculation, that's about 30 million yen left to pay. And we want it back now.
30 million? I could never...
Yeah, I guess you leave us no choice then. You're young enough, still, should earn us plenty of cash out on the street.
No!
And I know plenty of sickos who pay top dollar for the little kid you got.
What? You can't!
Those are the terms of the deal. You work for us until every last yen is paid back, got it?
Your brat's gonna fetch a pretty price too. Probably bringing more than you.
Leave her alone. My daughter. She's the only family I have left. Please. At least spare her. Please.
Hey, get her out of here. The kid'll be out in front of that arcade like usual. I'll go scoop her up. Yeah, gotcha. Oh, no need for that. Huh? Huh? And who are you? You ain't here to give us lip about the way we do business, are ya? Hmm?
Yeah.
I don't give a flying shit about your business. You can do whatever the hell you want. Then you're smarter than you look. How about you leave the kid and scram then? Yeah, that ain't gonna happen. See, there's two types of people in this world that really set me off. Huh? Dipshits who tear up dolls that I went through a lot of trouble to get a hold of. And fuckwits who prey on defenseless women because it makes them feel big. You fit both those bills, asshole. What? You motherfucker! You gotta screw loose, you skinny runt, cause you're betting to get your net broke. Shut your mouths and put up your fists so I can hurry up and beat the shit out of you. You scum. Oh, I'm going to enjoy this! Get the hell out of here! Scum like you! Just pissed the shit out of me! Disgusting! Get the hell out of here! Hey, I ain't done with you yet. I still gotta tear you up as badly as you tore up that poor doll. You know what, Majima? I like that idea. Have mercy! Ah, come on! I was just getting to the fun part. Daddy! Hey, you're right. Dad? Kind of weird. I was getting dolls for her and she... this is awkward. Yeah, this is the man who bought me all the dolls, Mommy. I call him Daddy. Oh, so that was you. My daughter talks about you all the time. I don't suppose I could ask your name.
Sure, it's Majima.
Majima-san, you've done so much for us. I don't know how to thank you.
It was nothing, really.
This is a little token of my appreciation. Please accept it.
Appreciate it, lady.
Daddy, I'm sorry.
Huh? What's wrong, Scamp?
I told you I'd take care of the dolls, but... please don't be mad at me.
Why would I be mad at you? It ain't your fault. Don't even sweat it.
But...
listen. Even with its eyes coming off and cuts all over, it ain't like it's dead. His heart's still beating. I can feel it.
Really?
Yeah. Heck, I'm living proof, ain't I? Take a look. One eye's gone, but I'm doing just fine.
You're right.
When Bunchen got messed up, you didn't throw it away, right? You're still clutching it close. It looks pretty happy, Daddy, about that, if you ask me.
Really? I'm gonna fix him up and keep him safe, then.
Yeah, you do that. Now I better get going.
Thank you for everything, Majima-san. Thanks, Daddy!
Daddy. It's got a nice ring to it. Well, glad I could do some good in the world. But unfortunately, I think that's where I'm going to end off this episode. So. Oh my god, is that seriously another... there you are, you little scamp. Anyway, so that's now where I'm going to end off this episode. On the next episode of Let's Play Yakuza 0, I think it's about time we head on back to our apartment. We did a crap ton this evening. So, remember to like, comment, subscribe, share, all that jazz, and I'll see you guys on the next episode of Yakuza 0.